like you drive, girl. I'm on your case today.
Today you want to stir me up, it seems to me.
Welcome to Caboolture Aero Club TV once again, and today I'm talking to Lindsay from the Caboolture Gliding Club. Hello Lindsay.
How are you, Peter?
I'm very well, and you?
Fine, thanks.
Today we're going to talk a little bit about what the gliding club does, what's the affiliation from the gliding club to the Aero Club, and Lindsay is here to tell us all about it. Now Lindsay, you've been flying for many years, have you?
I've been flying for 18 years.
Okay.
Bulk cover at Caboolture.
Have you always been gliding?
Yes.
Okay. So, and how did it start?
It started from me as a schoolboy. I was given a book by one of the adventure authors, and he described flying in an early primary glider in the 30s. And that created the interest in me, but unfortunately, life got in the way and I didn't get a chance to get into it until in my 40s.
Okay. And have you always been gliding from the word go?
Yes.
Okay. All right. That's fair enough. Now, Lindsay, tell us a little bit about Caboolture Gliding Club.
Well, Caboolture Gliding Club is one of the most recognised ab initio flying school for gliding in Australia.
Okay, and just quickly to interrupt you, what does ab initio mean?
Ab initio means from the start.
Okay.
From the very start.
So if I've got no experience in flying whatsoever and I want to learn to fly, then the Caboolture Gliding Club would be the place to go.
That's
is right. That correct?
That's correct. Okay. Yes, okay. Spot on.
Now, do I need a lot of money? Do I need qualifications?
No.
What's involved?
The big thing with gliding is it is all your tuition and everything, and the tugs and everything, is all voluntary.
Yes.
We all volunteer our time.
Okay.
You have to pay for the tug time, which is the tow up, and the aircraft time, the glider time.
Okay, so now we're talking about a tug time and tow up time.
Yes,
it
yes.
means so there's an aeroplane that tows us up into the air, right? You've
right.
got to pay for that.
Yes.
And then tow up time is the time that you fly, maybe, or how long it takes you to. How does that work?
The tow up time in our club, we work that by every 100 feet. We have a charge on that.
Yeah.
And now normal towing here is to about the 3,000.
Yes, yes.
Around about that, and then the glider just goes to the glider time.
Okay.
And the tug returns back to the someone else up.
So can I assume then, Lindsay, that it's actually a fairly cheap way of flying? It's a cost-effective way of getting into the air?
Yes, that is right.
Yep.
It is. It used to be regarded as a very, very economical way.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, costs have gone up,
mm-hmm.
but it is still, when I look at other forms of learning to fly, it is still the most competitive.
Yeah. And then I believe gliding is really what we would call the seats of the pants flying. What does that mean for us?
Well, it's okay for you powered fellas to say it's seats of the pants, but to us it is the natural way of flying.
Yes, yeah.
The way I term it is the powered pilots knock the air into submission to enable them to be up there by the propeller or their jet, whatever.
Yeah.
Whereas the glider pilots, we massage the air, we coerce the air to help us stay up there.
And I suppose by that you mean really we've got to look for the updrafts, for the currents that'll take our aeroplane up, and the challenge is really to stay up there as long as we can, and that's where most of the enjoyment comes from, is that correct?
That is where the big enjoyment comes.
Yeah.
In our training, in getting a pilot to solo status, which is our big aim here at Caboolture, is to get people to status, to solo. We teach you a certain amount of how to stay up there, but basically it is to be able to control an aircraft under all circumstances safely. Then we go into, when you're solo, then we can go into more of a bit more of a mentoring where we can assist you, we'll show you how to stay up there, how to read the clouds, how to fly the aircraft precisely. I have done 5-hour flights from Caboolture.
Wow.
And
using absolutely no fuel, using no assistance, all there on your own power, and no noise.
No noise.
No noise.
And the great thing with gliding is it is so I term it relaxing, because everything has to be out of our mind. Because every minute, every second, we have to be thinking about what we are doing. And so the flying of the aircraft becomes instinctive, and we are looking at where we're going to be, where is the next cloud, how am I...
Lindsay, tell me, with all of this, do you teach me to get safely back to the airfield if I don't have any engine?
Absolutely. That is the primary thing, that you never leave the airfield unless you never leave. One of the primary goals of laws of gliding is you never leave one landing spot without being able to get to another.
Okay.
You always have a landing.
So you go from your one area to the next. That's you see, maybe I can land in that paddock safely, and that's how you go. So you never leave the one spot.
And that will vary by height.
Yes.
The higher you are, obviously. Yeah. The broader span you've got.
Yes. And if you're high enough, it could be 10 kilometres away, is that correct?
And more.
Yes.
20, yeah. 25, 30 kilometres.
Now, Lindsay, I've been here many, many years, and I think what a lot of pilots might not know, or a lot of people might not know, is that the Caboolture Gliding Club is really a separate entity from the Caboolture Aero Club. Although the gliding club would be operating under the auspices of the Aero Club. So how do I, as a pilot or as a prospective gliding pilot...
Charlie, Caboolture Golf Line 1, Flintering Cash, lined up and rolling, runway 12, local flight to Tokyo.
So that's the benefits of having an interview on the runway. But how do I, as an aspirant pilot, get involved in the gliding club? How do I get to know you guys? Because coming to the Aero Club doesn't necessarily get me to the gliding club as such.
Basically, for the gliding club, we are a separate entity. We do operate with the Aero Club, but we are a totally separate entity. Yeah. We come under the Gliding Federation of
Australia. Perfect. 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 Perfect.
Which is the federation of all the gliding clubs and all pilots. You have to be a member of that.
Yeah.
But as far as learning to fly, it's a matter of coming out to the airfield. We fly every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, weather permitting, and turning up and filling out a membership form, and that's about it, and then away you go.
I think what I want to ask you is, often come to the front of the airfield, I see the gliding airplanes flying, but I can't see the fire card, I can't see you guys. So how can an outsider come to the airfield and get in touch with you straight away and know you can get a flight?
Well, our website is www.glidingcaboolture.org.au.
Yep.
And that will give you the contact numbers.
Yep.
And also our contact number, which one of our members carries with him, phone with him all the time.
Yep.
0418 713 903.
Okay, and I also have that below on the screen here for us right now.
Now, that will, Garrett will be able to tell you if and when we are flying, and he can arrange for you that if you say you're going to be at the car park, someone will be at the car park at a certain time, he can arrange for you to be picked up. The other side that we do too is we do air experience flights, where people can come up for, with a short-term membership, they can fly in 9 days, but most people just come up and do a flight. This gives them the experience of what gliding is all about.
That sounds very
good.
That's
enough to give people, I think, most of our members, in fact, I would venture to say most gliding members, certainly in Australia, start gliding by coming up to see what it's like.
Okay, and before we go, if I want my daughter to fly, or I want to take my grandmother for a flight, best would then be to go to your website.
Go to the website.
And call the telephone number.
Yes.
And then make a booking from there. That's about the best.
That's the best way.
Do happen to arrive at the airfield and I still can't see you guys, do you have a board at the front
or a telephone number that I can phone? Yes. And ring that and go for it.
So best is obviously to use the website, but if I can't, I can come to the board.
Well, the website will give you details, but the best all round is to ring Garrett, and he can arrange to pick up.
Lindsay, lastly, before we go, the costs. What are the costs involved?
Okay.
Just roughly, just give us a summary.
The rough cost for our air experience flights start at $150 and go up from that. It depends on how high you are towed, which gives a different length of time.
And then to complete my license, if complete, I want it from start to finish?
To complete, to go right through, would cost you somewhere in the vicinity of $2,500 to $3,000.
That's not a lot of money at all, eh?
But the big thing that it depends on is you have to come out as often as you can.
Yes.
And that is the big thing.
Yes.
And then natural aptitude.
Okay.
And natural aptitude, if you've got natural aptitude and you can get out here very often, you will go solo very quickly.
Yeah. And will it take me between 2 months and or will it take me 2 years?
It depends again on you. You're going to have to do probably somewhere between 35 and 60 flights.
Yes.
Depends again. If you can come out every weekend for, if you came out every weekend for about 3 weekends straight, all day every weekend, you'll be solo very quickly.
Yeah.
But if you come out every fortnight, you might be 12 months or
more. Okay.
So that's purely up to you.
Yeah. Well, Lindsay, thank you very, very much. It's really nice talking to you. And I think on a lovely day like today, I mean, anybody wants to be here, isn't it?
Yes, and be up underneath those clouds and, and going kilometres.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye.